150? Yeah. Who's got a big head? Yeah. My God, they're all big. And one man aside. Right then. Where's the little kitty? You were big ones. Yeah. You're all big ones. Where's the little kid? Where are the tiny tops? Where? Right. Little chalky hat, so £1.50. There's a little girl there. Give it to her. Thank you. What else we got? Right, who wants a mug? Right, we've got thousands of these. They're only 85p. Catch! Right, real cool. We've got bugs. They're only 25p. We've got millions of them. Look at this. A regular one sponge. They're 60p. We've got thousands of them. Thousands. Radio 1 badge is 20p. A Roadshow pen, who wants that? Yeah. Right, we want to see you all buy one then. One to the back, they're only a pound. Key rings, 50p. Yeah. Right, who wants a t-shirt? Yeah. Right then. What do, I'll give this t-shirt away if we can find the naughtiest lady. Who's naughty here? There's not many hands. Oh, come on! Hang on! Who wants this? Come on, man. Come on! Come on! Bring it forward! Come on! No! That's right, take it all off! Come on! Come to the front! Do you want it up front? Come on! Come on! Come on, give us some enthusiasm! Come on! Right. That's right, keep walking. Where's the cameras? Now's the time to get some pictures. Because something might happen here. Who wants this Radio 1 jacket? Oh, I've only got this one. I can't keep... Now, if you want some, they're good in the world. They're £10.95. I can't give this away. Really? They're £10.95. If you want any of these, they're good in the world. Hang on a minute. Right. Who's come and wants a shopping bag? Yeah. All week, I've never given this bag away. Sorry? What happened? Right, someone over this side. Who wants this bag? Right, the £2.95, okay? Okay, give a big stand now, welcome to Peter Powell!
Hold it, thanks. Come here, Dave. I've never seen your legs before. We've worked with each other for 2 years now. And those are a fine pair of pins, my mate.
Yours. Eh? Proud of yours.
Got more hairs than I have.
Yes,
great deal more. That's only surprising. Every time we come here, we like to just sort of wander out amongst the folks and see us go. Every time I come out, I lose half the hairs off my legs, which is a shame. Excuse me. Just, oops. I wish I wasn't quite so small, because every time I do this, I take my life in my hands. Well, I call it my life. Right, something we got. Where is that young lady who I just blimped to the back there, who took her... Well, I'm making a beeline up there, I tell you. No, it's just one that's a rip. Okay. Hello, mate. All right. Hello, my dear. Oh, I'm sorry. I see I've got an enormous handful here, so... Sorry, my love. Sorry, I wish I'd asked you. Alright, kids, alright. Oh, that hat. That's all right. That's all right. Right. Where is she? Where is she? Darling! Darling! I can't. I'm coming as quickly as I can. Remember your
shut
plan?
Up.
Boom, shut up. Terrific. That's all right. That's all right. Folks, can I just explain that the success of the show now is based really and truly on your shoulders, much more than any of us, well, because with the enthusiasm and everything you put in for the show, it makes it sound much better for those folks back at home. Stop stroking it. My leg. Listen, this is a family show, right? Not a drunken orgy. I want to try and find a young star DJ if I can, right? Someone who's... No, I mean, very, I've met you before. Ah, no, he's undoing the shoelaces. Tell you what. No. I want to find someone who's definitely under 10. Oh, hey. You. You do those shoelaces that are having moustache off. A DJ who's 10 and under, right? That was a right little horror, a right little mark. How old are you, mate? I hate you too. How the hell am I going to walk around with shoelaces dark like that? Where is he? Let's look at it. How old are you? Ted, come here, come here. You're a pretty big ten if you ask me. Oh, you can't! What's your name?
Peter Benson.
Peter Benson, is it? Pete, would you be confident enough to be able to broadcast to 8 million folks on the radio this morning?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, if I was to say what's the best thing about radio, what would you say?
I don't know.
No, that's not good. You can't just say, tell her. Yeah, anyway, it's the start of the channel today. Peter Benson, oh, what's the best thing about radio? I don't know. That's not good. So no, you've got to have lots of go, lots of determination, lots of courage and conviction. Anybody else reckon they can do it who's got lots and lots of conviction? And there's a right little loud mouth. Come here, Ian. Come here. Listen, this is really ridiculous. What's your name?
Jonathan.
Okay, John, how are you?
Ten.
Yeah, ten, are you? You're a Human League fan, are you?
Yeah.
Okay, what's the last two records Human League had? Hey, and a good hit record it was that, we all liked her, didn't we?
Yeah.
Have you got a girlfriend here?
Yeah.
Do you like girls?
Yeah.
How do I pass to say you are with a nice old girlfriend? Would you like that?
No.
Damn, no, it's all this damn man business. I'll tell you what we'll do. Listen, you look back through that lot there, right? Look back through that lot there. Make contact with the producer, Dave Atkin, and start looking at a script, okay? As to what you're going to say on the radio. Okay, he's the star DJ today. Right. Now then, okay, if you're going to do your shoelaces up, I'm going to go barefoot today. One pair of shoes coming over, lads, watch it. Go! No! I've got holes in the socks again this morning. Time to encourage me. Who has a sock? Have a smell of that. Vintage, that one. All in a sock. Vintage sock. That's better. Well then, right, a rocking granny or a rocking granddad. So break down the age barrier today, right? I want any grandmothers, will they stand up? Any grandmothers stand up. Especially grandmothers who are into Elvis Presley, right? Hello, darling. Are you into Elvis Presley? Have you got a good voice on you? Eh? Can you sing? I bet you can. How old are you? About 21 or something like that. Also, is there any other grannies here? Really old, ancient grannies who are dead proud of what they are, what they stand for. Where are they? There must be one or two around. Where are the families at? Get off their legs. He's a fella too. What's your business? There must be one or two grannies around here who are into Elvis Presley. Where are they? Hello, Mr. Van Dyne. Where are the sunglasses? Where are the sunglasses?
She's hiding, Pete. She's hiding.
Sorry, Tim. I didn't mean to put the microphone down there. Where is she? Let's have a look at her. Oh, sorry. Hello, my love. Hello. Oh, gorgeous granny.
Yeah,
all right.
Yes, thank you.
Now listen, would you like to take part on the radio show today?
You've got to sing though, haven't you?
I know, there's been a laugh. Are you lonesome tonight?
I'm lonesome now.
Another guy! Will you stand up? Ladies and gentlemen, would you please give our rocking granny today a round of applause? What is your name, my sweet?
Ivy Calander.
Calander. Right, Ivy Calander. From where, then?
Freshwater.
From Freshwater, okay. So listen, you relax here with the folks, and then I see you come up stage with Mentor, okay? And you show these youngsters what singing is really about. Yeah, you bet you will. Right. Good. Bits and pieces, folks. Who wants to get by bits and pieces? That t-shirt would look terrific with a bucket of water down. I can't resist that t-shirt with a leopard skin on the side of it. What is your name, my love? Penny DeBell. Okay, do you want to be on Bits and Pieces, then? You realise the only reason, don't you? No, just one of you. Penny, you're on Bits and Pieces, okay?
What was your name, Pete? Sorry.
Penny, Penny to Bell, David. Penny to Bell. Well, he always is pretty good, does he? Now, where are you from, Pen? From where? Black Gang, are you? Right. I want you to find two holidaymakers, right? And two... What is your name, my love? And where are you from? Where? You're from Cowes? Terrific. What's your name? Leslie Ann? You realise it's the t-shirt I'm after, so... Because I can't wait to soak it. Right, you're on bits and pieces. Leslie Ann, right. Now then, holidaymakers now. Two holidaymakers. Hold on. Couple of guys, you're all there now. Couple of guys. Well, you know you're pretty good, do you?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Simon Dean.
Where are you from, Simon?
North Chapman, Sussex.
That'll do us. We'll take you for bits and pieces. Look, let's go one side now. Find us someone from the other side. Oops. Ow. Whereabouts? See you later. Oh, he had a go. Nah, he doesn't have a go. You know, where are you from, though? Where are you from? From Derby? Do you want a crack at it?
Yeah, go on, man.
What's your name?
Carmeloy.
Say again.
Carmeloy.
Right, it's on bits and pieces. Now, what I'm trying to do is... Hello, darling. Well, he goes, we're coming to the mileage up that area, right? So I went to the mileage in the very back, I went to the mileage in the front. I want to do as much of the programme as I can from amongst the audience. So those of you who are sitting down, I appreciate it. It gives us a chance to sort of come out there and get ourselves organised. Oh, in the middle. Oh, hello. Is there one girl here who's on a Todd and totally fancy full and here? Where's the couple I met last night who were madly and passionately in love with each other? I can't remember. Eh? Was it you? No, it wasn't. Yes, it was. Was it? What's your name? Well, where's the other? Get your lady to stand up. Are you sure it was you two? Oh, we had you two actually on it last night, didn't we? Yeah, we had you two. You're still together. God, you are! I don't believe it! You met the disco last night and you're still together. Crazy. It isn't where I get it. Sorry. Tell me about that. Sorry about that. Thing is, you did actually take part. There was another couple who were head up on the stage. There they are. I found you. See, I didn't forget, did I? Would you two like to bring you up to the front of the stage, right? And we'll sort you out a bit later. I've got a record for you. I'm going to find out about your love life and what else has been going on when you're on holiday. Now then, one girl is on her own, right? One girl is on her own. Oops. One girl is on her own. And it... little older than you, my dear. Little older than you, I think. No. One girl is on her own. And it... Take your glasses off. Take your glasses off. Do you want to come on the stage? Here we go. Right, so let's get back up here. Oops, excuse me, ma. Just jump. Ow. Where is she now? Where is she? Sir? Oh, sorry. Where is she? Where is she now? Where's she gone? She was over here somewhere. I've lost her. Where is she? Where is she? Oh, here she is. Hello, my dear. Just come with me. Right. Come on. Run. Up there. Oh, sorry. Careful. Sit. What's your name?
Carol,
where from?
Newcastle.
Okay. Now, Carol, this is really just to give you a chance of a lifetime, because I know that you've been on your own for how long now?
Where?
How long have you been on your own for?
You got the wrong one?
No. How long?
Cover?
Oh! Yes. Oh, that's the wrong one! Oh, God! Sorry, dear. Sorry. Right there, hold on. God. Where is she? Come on. Right. What's your name?
Carol.
Hold up! Where are you from?
Newport.
Right, now Carol, how long have you been on your own?
4 weeks.
4 weeks? Without a man of your life?
I know, terrible, isn't it?
It's a terrible shame. We will amend that. Describe to me exactly what you'd most like in a man. What colour eyes?
Blue.
What colour hair?
Brown.
Brown hair, blue eyes. Moustache or a beard?
Neither.
No social. What age?
20.
20 years of age, right. Wearing shorts or trousers? Or a skirt?
Shorts.
Shorts. How long do you like it?
Put on.
His hair.
That long.
Well, that's sort of down to about 6 inches there, but okay, fine. Right, now then, you see Big Butch Dave here, Carol? I know you like this bit, Dave. Listen, you can pull hairs out of his legs if you wish. Now, will you hold Carol's eyes up? No. Face into his chest, Carol. That's the girl. Right, lovely. Right, now then. 20 years of age, right? Well, blue eyes, brown hair. No moustache or a beard, right? Listen, you wait. No moustache, no beard, brown eyes, blue hair. Blue eyes, brown hair. He comes from far too near to where she was, so I suspect she might have got... Huh? Well, look, you can't just leave your girlfriend, the one right here, and go... Let's try and find someone who's... It's definitely 20, and no moustache or a beard.
Yeah.
Okay, wearing shorts. Right, wearing shorts, no moustache or a beard. Any offers? Any other offers? Anyone actually fill that description? No moustache or a beard. Anyone else fill that description? Anyone else? If not, I have to give... Anyone else? He hasn't got shorts on. That's not shorts. 20 years of age, blue eyes, brown hair. Go on then, Butch, come here. Come here then, Butch. Oh, Carol, I can't believe what we found for you. Carol, this is going to be a whole day and a half for you today. Can you do your flies up before you come out on the stage, please? Oh, you haven't got any? Fine. Right, turn around here. God almighty, you fit the description. Oh, hold on. Well, that's all right. Listen, just repeat after me now. Carol, from the first time.
For the first time.
I saw you. Get on this.
Stage.
I knew.
That I wanted to.
Make you. An offer. That you could never refuse. I'm going to carry you in my arms to the goodie-mobile.
Uh-oh.
Where? At my expense.
At your expense.
Is that so stupid? I'm going to buy you any of the Radio 1 gear that you want to buy, and also for myself as well.
You're going to buy me and her all the goods that I want and she wants.
And she's going to stay with you for the rest of the morning.
Well,
you don't know, Carol. You haven't seen what you got yet. What do you reckon?
Could be.
Okay, good. Wait, right there. Carol, for one morning only, all expenses paid, the man of your life. Have a look. What do you reckon? What? What do you reckon? Out of 10.
Five!
Five's good enough! Five is better than nothing. Carry her to the goodie, buy her as many goodies as she wants, right? Bring her back here and we'll check you out with somebody else a little bit later on, okay? Alright, you just take it nice and easy, fella. Give me a round of applause, would you, for Carol. I forgot your name. Gary, is it? Okay, Gary, off you go. How about that, Carol? Getting lifted away with a hunk like that, you can't ask for any more. Couldn't ask for more. Now then, has anybody heard of Bow Wow? Because we've got a special surprise guest coming on a bit later on, and that's Annabella from Bow Wow. She's going to come and say hello, so look forward to that in a bit. The other thing I want to do is to make sure that you've all got your vocal cords all tuned up, because I want to make sure everyone back at home, about 8 million folks going to be listening to this show, so I want to make sure that everybody back at home knows that we're living and sitting in the sun, Jerry, okay. So can you just clear your throats a minute? Just... Let's try the every card, Dave.
The Radio 1 Roadshow.
One more for you, I think.
Today, live from Yabaland, Sandown, Isle of Wight, with Peter Powell.
Right, that is it. For the actual show, we've got to do it twice as loud, right? And keep it going twice as long. Hello? Come on here. Come over here. Come here. Come and say hello to us. Oh, go on. Just very quickly. Got a nice treat for you. I've got a really nice big treat for you. Got to, yeah, look. Come on through. Now listen, now listen. I've got a t-shirt, and a mug, and a sticker, and a keyring, and a radio unbug. No? No, Tracy, I'm not looking at you, Tracy. He's a cracky little lad. Who's, is he your son? No. Sorry. Who's, just friends? No, I know. Friends from the other right, yeah? You're from the other way, on the other, where from? From Shanklin. Right, let's just have a quick breakdown, find out who's from where. Those from Shanklin, should have put on the air, right? Little Paul. Those from Sandown, should have put on the air. Okay, those from Yarmouth. Those from Yarmouth. Those from Newport. Right, quite a contingent from Newport. Now, the world is local. Right. Benbridge, those from Benbridge. Those from Benbridge. Those from Blackgang. Blackgang area. Okay, who's coming up from the mainland, from Portsmouth? I'm impressed, thank you for coming over. Thank you for coming over. Any from Southampton here? Well, isn't it funny, every time you mention Southampton and Portsmouth, you get this, you know, get this heavy action between the two cities. From where? I can't hear. Can you stop? Where? Winchester? Who's going to... What other major towns are there on the island? Newcastle. Where's Newcastle? Right. Now, who's... Anyone come from Scotland? Anyone from Scotland? Anyone from Wales? Anyone? That's good. Anyone from London? Any folks come from London? Right. Now then, what we'll try and do is to mention as many times as we can. Obviously, when we do these dedications on the radio, we want full names and where you're from and that kind of thing. We've got the marriage, we've got bits and pieces, we've got the granny, we've got the young DJ, we've got Annabella coming along as well. But the rest of the show is basically totally up to you lot there, okay? So hopefully that cloud goes away. The sun is going to shine. What time are we going out? How long have we got now?
9 minutes.
So I'm just going to fiddle around the back here and just get myself organised. Right, it's just you lot out. Banners and posters will do about 12:15, okay? So until that time, keep them down because people at the back can't see. Alright? Good. So I'm going to sort things out. We'll be on the air in about 8 or 9 minutes. So you just want to sort of... your bum's getting wet by any chance. Have you got bum liners or anything like that? Can we... plastic pants or...
Didn't they bring their hair dryers?
Hair dryers?
Yeah, but they could have...
Dave, that's the most ridiculous idea I've ever heard. This guy,
you said it yesterday.
But hair dryers, did I? Oh, stop covering the lines. Right, I'll be with you in a short while. Just play some music, I'll get ourselves organized. Okay, young Jonathan is going to open the show for us today, right? So we'll just work out a script for him here, and then what we'll do is we'll let him actually start the show. Then we'll play the opening card, which is the sort of jingle of live from Yaveland, Isle of Wight. And then we'll have a mighty cheer from you lot. Then he's going to introduce the first record, and another cheer should be not only for the record, but also for young Jonathan as well, okay? So he's going to work out a script with him.
Simon, welcome and hello everybody. My name's Jonathan Lockery, I'm 10 years old, and I come from Manchester. And it's my pleasure to open up the Radio 1 Roadshow from the Isle of Wight for 1982.
The Radio 1 Roadshow!
Today, live from Yabberland's Sandown, Isle of Wight, with Peter Powell!
Here's the first single from Dex's Midnight Runners, and it's called Come On Eileen.
Thank you for letting me in. Would you please give Beyond Jonathan a big round of applause? Smegging Rollins and the Miracles, absolute classic from the summer of 1970. One of my favourite oldies, I think. Tears of a Clown. Playing that for summer to middle school, the staff and pupils from Lisa, Mandy, Haley and Sarah. One for all who go to Burhurst School, or Bohurst School, that's in Lippock, and Carisbrook High, the Isle of Wight. Everyone else who knows us, from Clara Robinson and Colette Stockley. One for Modern Studies in Coventry, the Polytechnic football team, for Pete, Tina and Sean, and that's for Natalie and Yvonne, mum and dad and family. One here is for Kathy in Luton, near Puttridge, and Andrea in Shillington, from Robert Howard, who's been following the Roadshow around for the last few days. For David and Mark and Nick and Paul, and especially Tony Everett, and also for all the folks who looked after us at the Clifftops Hotel. Can't thank you enough for your fantastic hospitality, excellent food, great service, and a great reception. Thank you to the Clifftops. Right, also for Jackie, that's the girlfriend of Phil. And Jackie works at Michael John's Hairdressers in Newport. It's Modern Romance, up to news, on the Roadshow, with Cherry Pink and Apple Blossom White.
Ivy Callender, please come up to the stage. Our rocking granny, Ivy Callender.
Okay, so we're back into the news in about a minute or so. And when we come out of the news, can you try and give us a really long, sustained, and really good simulator? Give us a stick, an enormous cheer, because it sort of gives the program 1 second lease of life for those folks back at home who are listening, right? And they love to hear the cheers, so they think, oh, wish I was there and all that business, all right? So give us a real stick, keep it going for a long, long time, all right? Right into the record. Hello, my dear.
This is owning their own animals and employing one of the family or something to train them, but I own my own animals and work for whichever circus is paying us the most pennies.
It looks a mighty big top that we've got directly behind us.
It is a super circus. We started...
Ow! Excuse me! I'm sorry, this is just put... No, it's okay, it's fine. Ow!
It is a super circus. We started last year, and this is our second season, and it's possibly one of the most successful shows in the country.
We hear of circuses running into sort of financial trouble. I mean, is the trend up, or just, thank you, just taking his glass better. I've got this pour on my... They're beautiful. Is the trend up or down, do you reckon?
No, we find the business very good. We've just come back from Southern Ireland. We've been very busy here. In fact, we were supposed to finish here on the 29th of this month, and we're now staying till the 31st, so business is good.
I think one of them has just made a snort. I'm not sure what it's fun it is.
I thought it was you, Peter.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Oh, I don't believe it! It's chubby than me!
That's very lucky. It's very lucky it wasn't over me.
Martin, what else have you got? I thought I smelt something. I didn't realise what it was. What else have you got in the circus?
Well, as I say, we've got a super show, Moroccan tumblers, we have got horses, clowns, obviously some big lions working there, not tigers, lions working, and a great dog act, and also some pigeons that not only fly about the audience, but disappear.
I'm going to be meeting 12-year-old Natalie Dunn a bit later on. She's going to treat me to teach me a trick or two on the high wire, isn't she?
No, on the trapeze.
On the trapeze, is it? Thank goodness for that. Listen, I hope these two cubs are absolutely gorgeous. Would you folks give Martin and the cubs a round of applause for coming out today? I'm looking around here. What is your name?
Georgia.
You're dying to stroke them, aren't you? Do you want to go and stroke one of the cubs? There you go. Is the cubs bigger than you? I don't know. So I should be introducing Anna again actually on the radio when we come live. So will you give her a nice cheer when I introduce her live on the radio, please?
Yeah, we were just on the tour actually in Manchester. I got a gig in Manchester last night, and I must say it was really great. It was alright.
That's the beginning of quite an extensive tour, I think.
Yeah, we're doing a couple of dates in Hammersmith during the weekend, and we're doing one tonight in Southampton.
Now, there's a few people from Southampton tonight. We got this gig tonight, which is the Radio on Beach Party, which you're performing. We've also got some tickets for the show, which we're going to give to the mileage contestants a bit later on. Not mileage contestants, but some pieces contestants a bit later on. Anyway, that should be a laugh tonight. Malcolm McLaren found you, I think, didn't he?
Yeah, I think so.
Or did you find him?
Well, he sort of waltzed in, and I had an audition given to me. I was off the chance of being a big star. So.
And C30,
C90 go, yeah.
That was the virtually sort of first sort of breakthrough on it, as far as.
That was about home taping that song. So bring along cassettes, and you know, you're welcome, whatever.
Yeah, because the band don't really stick to the sort of the steady format that most bands are meant to follow, do you at all?
What format's that?
Well, I mean, your publicity is fairly extreme, isn't it? And also, some of the songs that you do have got fairly dicey lyrics, should I say.
Black Gang.
Black Gang. It's very famous, isn't it, for its sort of fantasy theme park?
Yes, it is.
Do you, I mean, as a local of Black Gang, do you actually go around it? Have you ever been around it?
I've been working there since I was about 7.
Have you? On what particular part of it?
Well, I'm usually in the bazaar part, selling the gifts to people and everything.
Is it sort of in the family?
Yes, it is.
Is it? You must be worth a fortune.
I wish I was.
All right, good luck with bits and pieces. Do you want to say hello to anybody?
Yeah, I'd like to say hello to my mum and dad, to Dave, Tom, Lyle, and anybody else who knows me.
All right, love. Good luck with bits and pieces. And you're prepared to take the bucket of water as a consequence as being the loser, aren't you?
I think so.
Yeah, right. What's your name?
Carl Malloy.
Carl, where are you from?
Derby.
From Mount Derby?
Yes.
So you're on holiday here, are you?
Yes.
And what have you been up to so far since you got here?
Well, no.
Oops. No, you got a load of friends, have you?
Yes.
And the family?
No, come on, my own friend.
Okay, what's his or her name?
Phil Kelly.
Anybody else want to say hello to?
All my mates at work, my mum and dad, and everybody I know from Whitecliff Bay.
All right, good luck with bits and pieces. Good later on. And our third contestant is?
Simon Denley.
Okay, Simon, where are you from?
In North Chapham, Sussex.
You're a member of the Roadshow Act, are you?
That's right, yeah.
So you come with friends or family or what?
I come with family.
Okay. Yeah. Second week or first week?
First week.
So, weather's great today. Has it been a bit dicey or what?
A bit windy, yeah, the last week.
What sports are you into, if any?
I'm an athletic. I compete in athletics.
What, running or hurdling?
Running.
Who do you want to say hello to now?
I'd like to say hello to Worthing Athletic Club, Hosmerville Athletic Club, Mum and Dad, my sister's birthday tomorrow, and my brother Paul.
And prepare to the consequences if you lose bits and pieces.
Oh yes, of course.
Alright, and your name is?
Leslie Ann Cochran.
And where are you from, Leslie?
Cowes.
From Cowes, good, nice to see you there. There are so many different areas of the island, it's so difficult to mention them all, but you've got the most fantastic blue eyes, I've just noticed them. I've actually spelled that on them. Did you want to say hello to anybody?
Yes, my love to Jim, who's in the crowd.
Is that your boyfriend?
Yeah.
I shouldn't say. Sorry, Jim. Sorry, fella. Sorry, Jim. Big lad too, right? Who else?
Bumchin, who I share my house with. And all the lads at Marex. And Jan, the secretary. All the lads at Millwise, especially Tim. And all my friends back in Cairns.
All right, it's been done. And play to the consequences of the bucket of water if you lose.
Yeah.
Looks terrific on you if you die. Whoops. Right, I'm going to play bits and pieces as well, which comes right next.
One more record to bits and pieces!
Take it away, would you wanna stay? There's no one else in me. Take it away, wanna hear you play till the lights go down.
Luckily these shirts are see-through, I don't think they are. Hey, listen, if you thought, hang on, you four contestants, then I'll speak to you first before you go anywhere else. Well, really, not long, 50 minutes to go or whatever. Okay, birthday today from his girlfriend Helen, Charlotte, Rosemary and Sue and all at Fisher's Brook. One here on a candy tin. Say hi to everyone who went to Aaron from Carisbrook. Hi, with Mr. Clark and Sam Turner, Ron Weeks and Mickey Taylor. I think we've done one from Carisbrook High already. Liz and Hessian. Say hi to Woody, Phil, Damien, Paul, Nick, Helen, Kate, Kath and everyone down Cornwall. Also to Adrian and Dominic and Chris and Richard Kettle and Rob, Sharp and Gail and Mandy and Ronald. And all the beer at the beer in Southsea who've come across for the day. This is Trio. And da da da. It's 19 after 12. We're on the road show. Let's see if they're still awake. Right, we're living on in the other place. Oh, you're a cracking bunch, you are. Now, you show me first of all the first basic move that you do on a trapeze. What is it?
Well, I can't explain it really.
Oh, well, you go and do it, and I'll explain how it's done then. Right, so Natalie now, 12 years of age, taking her shoes off, she's going to hold on to the ropes, right, pull herself up, and wraps her legs over the top, and sits in the trapeze. Right, now then Natalie, what I want you to do is to show me the first basic move. For instance, is there any way that I could hang from that trapeze by my legs? Would that be possible? Well, you get on down and see if we can fix it up. Come on down. Alan, would you hold on to this microphone, would you, and keep it very close to my mouth. Are we going to use a chair to get up, are we? Oh, fine, right. Hold on. Well, Snoopy, would you hold on to the microphone?
Right.
I got to put my first foot through. Hold on. Got to put my... Hold on. Got to put my first foot through the first thing, right. Now I got to twist around. Got to put the second foot through the second thing. Right. It's like a seesaw. Give me the chair, please. Push me, do something. Push me. I want to fly. Okay.
And the maximum security, even after plastic surgery. So go on and squeals at the FBI. We can make a deal, make it worth your while.
There's a gentleman that's going round, turning the truck upside down. Storm vision, ha-cha-cha-cha. He's an old ex-con that's been away. Now he's back, no one say. Storm vision, ha-cha-cha-cha.
After all the time,
well, to do trapeze. What I'm going to do now is stand on Alan's shoulders. He's one of the engineers. I'm going to grab for the wire. Hold it. Don't move, Alan. We are now going to do something very special, Alan. This has never been done ever before. We are now going to do a loop-de-loop through the hole, and you're going to catch me the other side, right? Yes, you are. Don't you move on. Keep your shoulders there up. You ready for this one? Right, hold up. Keep, Bob, take this microphone. There. Hold up to my mouth, Bob. There you go, right. Ready, Alan? Ready? Ready? What? Okay, up, 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 down, down, oh! Oh! This is Devin Barry. The one that tried me in the sun. In the sun, either on a common or a beach or on a slope like we are now, and broadcast the radio show to so many thousands of folks. Obviously, it's the audience here who've made it possible. It's been the audiences right around the whole week that I've been doing on the South and Southeast Coast, which have made it absolutely fantastic week for me. Behind the scenes was a gang who worked really, really hard to bring the shows to you, and I'd like you now to put your hands together, please, for the firstly, the two guys who drive everything around, for John and Bob. Would you please put your hands together for the two guys? Thank you, both of you. To the two engineers who twiddle everything to make sure it all goes out down the line. To Aaron and inside the cubicle, Keith. Would you put your hands together for those two? Thank you. To Darcy, who keeps me and Dave absolutely in order. To our secretary, Darcy. And to the boss of the show, please, the guy who's led me right around the coast, Dave Atkey, the producer. Thank you, Dave. Smiley's crowd as well have been absolutely magnificent. It's again been a situation of us coming out to you and you responding and coming out to see us. We thank you very much to all the places we've played this week. We thank very much the people of the Isle of Wight and the police and the St. John's Ambulance and all the other people. Also to Yaverland Yacht Club, who led it. Yaverland. Oh, it's terrific. I started the show with it wrong and I finished with it wrong. Yaverland Yacht Club, who lends us the power so we could do the whole thing. Next week, the road show comes from East Undercliff Drive in Bournemouth with Tony Blackburn. From us, it's goodbye. Thank you for coming. Well, right, we'll see you again next year. Goodbye. Thank you. You've been an absolute pleasure to work for. Thank you very, very much for coming out. Thank you. I've got about 2 hours now, 2 to 3 hours to see as many of you as want to stay in the sun, all right? A couple of hours, Dave's just said. So if you want to say hello, be up there the goodie in about 5 or 10 minutes, all right? Thanks for coming out. Hope you enjoy yourselves. Hope to see you again next year. God bless you.
Just before you all rush off, can you just hold on a second? Can I just say to you that the queue will form down outside that orange sort of rope thing that's down the side there, around the back of the goodie and down that side. If you can form up in a nice orderly queue, we'll do as many as we can up to about 2:30. Everybody will try, we'll try and get an autograph done. So form up in a nice orderly queue, no pushing into the queue, and then everybody will be happy.